folks, Dagan here from PMTVUK, and today we're going to be talking about the Fender JagStang and what makes it so bloody special. The JagStang. If you're not familiar with this concoction of awesomeness, let's say, it was it's the brainchild of the one and only Kurt Cobain. If you're watching this and you're not a Nirvana fan and you're unsure why this is a thing, that's why. But I'm guessing 99% of the people who are watching this will know that this is Kurt's guitar he designed alongside the Fender Custom Shop back in 1993. Can do nice stuff as well. It's a very versatile guitar for how wacky and how game-changing and important Kurt and Nirvana and guitars of this ilk were back in the day, you know? So if you couldn't tell by looking at it and the name, it's a cross-pollination of a Jaguar and a Mustang. That's what makes it so special. The story goes, it was 93. Kurt loved his Nevermind Jaguar, that famous 65. I think Jaguar, you can see a picture of it on screen right now. Fender have done re-releases of that in the past. And then in the in utero days, he used his famous Mustang, the Sky-Stang, the famous Sky-Stang. And when it came to moving on from those guitars, he kind of wanted to cross-pollinate them together. That's the biggest phrase in this video, cross-pollination, kind of hybriding two guitars. Which is interesting because Kurt was famously anti-corporate. So with that, I don't know if this is just a guitar that he wanted for himself or there was plans to mass produce it in the day. Obviously that happened in 1996. And now with this run, which came out in 2021 to celebrate 30 years of Nevermind, they re-released them. But I don't know if the original plan back in the day was to release them to the public or not. Would Kurt like that? I don't know. His estate sure do, but I'm not sure what the crack was back in the early 90s. So bloody easy to play, ridiculously easy to play. So the story goes, Kurt went to the Fender Custom Shop in 93, then chatted to master builder Larry L. Brooks, who's made some fantastic guitars over the years. And again, the story goes that there was lots of back and forths with designs and concepts, because as you can see, the body's pretty much half Jaguar, half Mustang. Concepts back and forth and drawings and not the CAD designs around at the time, but that kind of design and stuff. I think it boiled down to Kurt cutting up two Polaroids of guitars and going, there we go, make that. And they're like, oh, that makes a lot more sense doing it that way. It's not just about the look though. It's so lovely to play. It's not just about the look though. Essentially it's two, it's combining this, his favorite elements of the Mustang and the Jaguar. So the main thing to note, 24-inch scale. I'm a very tall guy, I'm 6'3", and guitars look small on me anyways, but this is actually a shorter scale guitar, like a Mustang, like a Jaguar. I've got to quickly give a little shout out to one of my favourite channels on YouTube, and that's Nirvana Guitars. I've followed that dude for years, and he is an encyclopedia of all of Kurt's guitars. He knows all the nuances, all the little mods, all the little subtle changes and specific colours and stuff. The guy's an absolute legend. He's had the pleasure of playing and seeing some of Kurt's most famous guitars as well. At the competition Mustang from the Smells Like Teen Spirit music video. He's seen and played Jag-Stang 1 and the rest. So yeah, I can't stress enough. If you're a fan of Nirvana and Kurt's guitars, check out Nirvana Guitars. I'll link it in the description box down below highly recommend you do check it out. Anyways, let's get back into talking about these guitars. These ones are made in Mexico, the 2021 and as of right now, 2024. These are Mexican made. Obviously the OGs made for Kurt back in the day were the USA Fender Custom Shop. And in 96, they were made in Japan. They were Japanese made Fenders. Now they're made in Mexico and they're lovely. They come in two colors, just like Kurt's original prototypes did. Fiesta Red and Sonic Blue. However, I don't think he even got to see the Fiesta Red one. Correct me if I'm wrong down below, but I don't think he ever got to see that. He famously only ever played the Sonic Blue one. Famously for one show, one full show, he didn't put it down, and a couple of other songs here and there at different shows, which is a massive shame. It didn't get more airtime. There's only a few photos and videos kind of cutting about out there with him rocking the Jag-Stang. It's such a famous, iconic guitar. Who knows where it would have went in the future? Who knows? But yes, so Fiesta Red and Sonic Blue, they obviously come in left-handed models because Kurt and that. And I've got to say, they're so easy to play. They've got so much snap to them as well. That comes with the little lav mic there. Very snappy guitars. Of course, it's that classic recipe of an alder body and a maple neck. With it being 24-inch scale, like I say, it is naturally smaller because 24 is a smaller number than other guitars. But because of that, the strings are a bit stinkier. And everything's a bit closer together. So it is naturally, by nature, an easier guitar to play. It's a gloss neck, so it's lovely and smooth. And it's a slim C profile, four bolt neck joint as well. Slim C isn't slim in the sense of like, you might think it's like a Shred Charvel or an Ibanez Gem or something. It's just like a very nice feeling Fender C neck. Very vintage feeling, and that continues with the 22 vintage spec frets on a 7.25-inch radius, proper rosewood fingerboard. That's quite a curved radius, but it's the Sky-Stang 1 radius. It's an old Mustang radius, is what Kurt likes, and therefore it's what we all like as well, because it's absolutely mint. Another big old 70s CBS headstock up there as well. Synthetic bone nut, the truss rod adjustment is down period correct at the bottom right there for old school Mustangs and that. And as you can see, it's got the classic Fender Mustang bridge and tremolo, which is awesome. However, Kurt did modify his ever so slightly, and you can see from pictures and again with Nirvana guitars on YouTube, he goes in depth with this as well. So he flips this part around, so the bar is actually up here, but that then allows you to put the strings straight through the body as if it was a Les Paul, because usually on these guys, you have to string underneath, flip this around, straight through. That's what Kurt did. And he also swapped this bridge out for a Tunematic style bridge. This works awesome. Fantastic bridges. I think Kurt was just so used to it with that being on the Sky-Stang and the Nevermind Jaguar. That's why he did that, but out the box, you haven't got to change. They're not going to break or anything. They're awesome things, but Kurt did change his. Another thing that's slightly different to the OG prototypes is the pickguard. These guys, the Fiesta Red and the Sonic Blue, feature a four-ply polaroid pickguard. As you can see, on Kurt's original prototype, it was just single-ply white. I don't know if the plan was to eventually get a polaroid pickguard to Kurt because he wanted one of these from the beginning or what, but that's one of the differences if you see pictures and videos and stuff. Now, one of the main things, one of the coolest things, are the Fender Jag-Stang pickups. Now, these are unique to these guitars, the Jag-Stang humbucker and the Jag-Stang single coil. Now, this seemed to be Kurt's preferred setup. Humbucker in the bridge, single coil in the neck. It was the same on Sky-Stang 1, even though that had a single coil-sized humbucker. This is the same as that, just a full-size humbucker. And they were hotly debated, the pickups in this back in the day. Fender Texas Special in the neck, and it was originally a Damasio H3 in the bridge, but after some sleuthing online with Nirvana guitars and the rest, they realized, and I read it, it was actually a Seymour Duncan 59. It was custom made in white with a Seymour Duncan logo. This is obviously Fender's version of that, because Fender haven't got to outsource stuff from Seymour Duncan. They've got a big pickup shop and they can kind of just make them themselves. So that is what's in this guitar. Switches up top, Mustang style again, on off switches. When they're in the middle, they're off. When they're to the left or the right, neck pickup, bridge pickup, they're on. When they're both going the same way, they're both on in series. When they're going different ways, they're either pointing together or both pointing away, that puts them out of phase. Sound great. Or just keep one in the middle and one going left or right. all the classic Jag-Stang sounds you want. Pretend you could commit in front of the mirror. That's what I've been doing for the past 3 hours before I even turned on any of those cameras. One volume, one tone, that's kind of it. Oh, also, if you want to change a pickguard, it doesn't fit. A regular Mustang pickguard doesn't fit. So you've got to make your own. I think you can buy specific Jag-Stang pickguards, but if you want to cut them out yourself from a stencil, it won't fit. It's a very unique guitar. Very unique guitar. I think it's fantastic. Whether or not it would have seen the light of day if Kurt hadn't untimely, unfortunately passed away, we never know. Was it just for Kurt? Was it for the world? Well, it's here now and everyone can enjoy playing those iconic riffs just as much as me. I'm having a lot of fun doing this video and I hope you're enjoying it as well. So let's hear it some more. If you want to get one for yourself, obviously there's a link in the description box down below which will take you to pmtonline.co.uk. Left-handed, right-handed, Fiesta Red or Sonic Blue, just have your pick. I'm running into a Black Star St. James, but on the clean channel, I'm using a Boss DS2 to get the tones. I'll play a couple of riffs with this, and I've got a small clone as well. To get some chorus sounds. And then I'll play the regular distortion through the amplifiers to show you how an amp can encapsulate it without pedals. But until then, wasn't quick enough there, was I? Nice. It is a very aggressive guitar, but it can be nice, like, you know, the intro. Whereas there's some actual amp gain on the Ghost, you can hear it not just through a fuzzy DS1. So this is no distortion pedals going into a Black Star St. James 6L6. The gain's at 1 o'clock and all the EQs at 1 o'clock as well. I'm trying not to just play Nirvana stuff to show that how versatile this guitar can be, like punk rock and stuff. Has got a lot got a snap to it, has it?
That's just a humbucker as well. The neck pickup. Both pickups together sound amazing. Pick up by yourself now. It's got a bit of spank to it, hasn't it? But it's like notes fall out of it. I could never expect a song like that to be played on a guitar. And with that, I think that's all the side specs. I've got that right on the lens. It's like Anchorman, right on the lens. Anyways, that's all the side specs and sounds I can give you from the Fender JagStang. I think it's mint. Let us know what you think down below in the comments. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up and hit subscribe. You'll find us at Play Music Today on all social media platforms and me at Dagan on Instagram. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.